We see today limitations of dimensional analysis. We have already studied uses of dimensional analysis, and in that dimensional analysis there are three uses. So this dimensional analysis is useful for simple cases, but it is not generally used. That's why it has some limitations or drawbacks. So we see limitations or drawbacks of dimensional analysis. The value of dimensionless constant can be obtained with the help of experiment. We know very well, we have already studied in second use of dimensional analysis. In second use of dimensional analysis, we have obtained the period of simple pendulum, relation between period of simple pendulum, length of simple pendulum, and axis due to gravity. So we have obtained the formula for find the period of simple pendulum, t equal to k under root l by g. T means period, length of simple pendulum l, and g axis due to gravity, k is constant. This constant we have determined experimentally. That's why dimensional analysis is not useful to find the constant. That's why we can take on the value of k equal to 2 pi experimentally. So that's why the value of dimensionless constant can be obtained with the help of experiment. Second limitation is that, second limitation, dimensional analysis cannot be used to derive relations involving trigonometric, exponential, and logarithmic function. So dimensional analysis is not useful for trigonometric, exponential, and logarithmic functions. It is useful for simple cases. That's why I say already, it is useful for simple cases, and it is not useful for trigonometric, exponential, and logarithmic functions. Log x or log of base 10, etc. So these are the second, this is the second limitation of dimensional analysis. Dimensional analysis cannot be used to derive relations involving trigonometric, exponential, and logarithmic functions. It is not useful for trigonometric, exponential, and logarithmic functions. Third limitations is that this method is not useful. This method, is not useful if constant of proportionality constant of proportionality is not a dimensionless quantity. Dimensionless quantity. Third, what is third limitation? This method is not useful if constant of proportionality is not a dimensionless quantity. Now we know example, we see examples. Newton's law of gravitation. We know very well Newton's law of gravitation. In Newton's law of gravitation, gravitational force between two point of masses is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to square of distance between them. Means, if these are the two masses, m1, m2, are separated by distance r, then the gravitational force between these two point masses is given by F, directly proportional to m1, m2 upon r square. Gravitational force between two point masses is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to square of distance between them. Therefore, F equal to g m1, m2 upon r square. Means g is the gravitational constant. G is the gravitational constant. So that this method is not useful if constant of proportionality is not a dimensionless quantity. It is not a dimensionless quantity. So that this is the another limitations. So this method is not useful if constant of proportionality is not a dimensionless quantity. This is the third limitations. And fourth limitation is that this method is not useful if the quantities depends upon more than three dimensional quantity means M, L and T. Here, fourth limitation. This method is not useful if the quantity depends upon more than the quantity depends upon more than three dimensional quantity. This method is not applicable if the quantity depends upon more than three dimensional quantity M, L and T. So these are the limitations. Means we studied that dimensional analysis is useful for limited or simple cases, but it is not used generally, and these are the limitations. Okay, thank you.